Pajak from Everyday Energy Magic, and I would like to talk to you today about receiving. I have a teacher of mine. Her name's Beatrix Quintana. She's a lovely, wonderful person. And I go to her class about living by the light of the moon. She has a great book about living by the light of the moon. And one day she said, stop controlling by giving. Stop controlling by giving, because I'm a huge giver. I'm a huge people pleaser. Well, maybe recovering people pleaser. And I realized after she talked about giving as a way of controlling people, that I was using giving to control people, because I like to give a lot. And the flip side of that is being able to receive. And that is something I've been working on for a very long time. I think many women in our society are taught to be givers, but we are not taught to be receivers. We are not taught to receive well. We are told to say, oh, no, 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 thank you. I don't need blah, blah, blah. Or, oh, you shouldn't have. No, you should have. That's what I want to talk to you about today, is being able to receive. And I've read some of Brené Brown's books. If you haven't checked those out, those are very cool. She talks a lot about vulnerability. And this is something that rings a bell, obviously, with a lot of people, because a lot of people have been talking about her work. Vulnerability also leads to great, not only connection, but also power. It's a way to get empowered. It's a way to feel connection with others. And we have to be vulnerable to receive. And if you haven't ever heard that before, please take a moment and think about it. You have to be vulnerable to receive. And this is important in so many ways. Not only to receive love and affection, receive gifts, receive abundance from the universe, to receive good communication, but also to receive input that helps empower you. And I just feel like we don't put enough importance on being able to receive well, receive with grace and ease. And I wanted to share this thing I do with our family. I think so many times in our loving relationships with those who are closest to us, we don't always say the things that we might think that the other person would so love to hear. So love to hear. And I want to encourage you to please, please, please take a moment and tell the ones you love what you love about them. So here's what we do. And I started this, I don't know, maybe 5 years ago, something like that. So we have family meetings, and it's not every week, not even once a month. It's whenever we feel like we need to have one. And we'll, I have a whole worksheet on how to run a family meeting. But what I want to say about it is that the family meetings, the way we always end them, and the family meetings, let me just take a second and talk about this. They are for us to air concerns or talk about, like, summer's coming up. What do we want to do? Where do we want to go? Do we want to take a vacation? How do we want to set it up? Those kinds of things, or plans for Christmas, or maybe there's a concern in the family. My son had a concern. He wanted to call a family meeting yesterday. And so we did. We called the meeting. It's only three of us, so it's not like it's a huge meeting. We have to coordinate. And we are free to share what we want to share and raise any concerns we have and talk about anything that's going on. I also use it as a chance to check in with everybody, especially my son, and say, is there anything you need from me or dad to support you moving forward? Is there something else you want or need, either physically or emotionally, that kind of thing. But But the way we always end our meetings is my favorite thing ever. And I hope you will try and do this with your loved ones. We have this thing where we say one thing we love about each of the people at the table. So I would say one thing I love about my son, one thing I love about my husband, then my son would take a turn and say one thing he loves about me, one thing he loves about my husband, then my husband goes, one thing he loves about me, one thing he loves about my son. And sorry, I might cry because I get all emotional about this stuff. But the one thing that I realized last night when we were having our meeting was how much I rely on what words are spoken about me. When I'm sad or feeling not worthy or less than, I go back to what my loved ones said about me. And I really take what they say and I take it in and hold it and cherish it. We just don't hear those things enough, you know? And it's not like you have to hear them every day. It's not like you make that an everyday exercise, because then it probably wouldn't mean as much. But hearing what your loved ones love about you, it's priceless. And I think it shows my son what it means to communicate such deep feelings that you have for another person, and opening up a space where that's okay, and that real communication is appreciated and shown and displayed and received. I had to get to a place where I could hear what they said and take it in fully and receive it and believe it and trust it and call upon it when I'm sad and call upon it when I'm not feeling 100% myself or 100% confident. And in having that meeting, having that exercise of allowing for those to tell me what they love about who I love, to tell me what they love about me, you have to be vulnerable. You have to be vulnerable in that space, and you have to trust that they're gonna tell you something and they're gonna come up with something that they love about you. And in that exercise, I'm showing my son that it's okay to be vulnerable, it's okay to receive, it's okay to trust. It's okay to trust, love, and have those deep connections, because that's really, really what makes life worth living. Those deep connections, the love you feel, and putting words to that love and knowing that that's okay to put love into words and share it with those you love. I feel like that is gonna be so important for him when he enters marriage, when he has kids of his own. Even with friends, even with those loved ones near him that are friends, being able to communicate on that level is such a huge benefit. And it really does require that you learn to receive. You learn to be vulnerable and you receive. And it's my deepest hope that you go and try this with someone you love, someone you trust, and someone you love, and open yourself up to be a little vulnerable, because in so doing, you can receive the greatest gifts. And when you receive those gifts of love, guess what? Your energy goes up. Talking about everyday energy magic. Those words from a loved one, they'll carry you for a long time. weeks, if not years, I still remember things that they told me from years ago that now have become part of who I am, who I regularly think about as part of being part of myself. And what a gift. What a gift. So when you enter into that space, if you can, with someone you love, someone you trust, make sure what words come out of your mouth are from your heart about what you love about that person. That makes it so much easier for the other person to receive. Make sure you're coming from your heart center, and it opens up a space for them to come from theirs. So I hope you go try this week. Enjoy, be vulnerable, and receive well.